Welcome to the Dimp Digital Podcast. We're on episode number 73, and this time you've got myself, Apps, and Adkins. How you doing, mate?
I am damp.
Is that just because of the weather? Because it has been an absolute blower out there today.
It's a mixture of the weather.
Yeah.
And the juice is coming out my penis from all these announcements.
Well, yeah, we've got a lot to get through. It is Tuesday here, so we have now seen all the major publishers' press conferences. Now, as we're speaking now, Nintendo are doing their Treehouse event, which I think is running nearly all day, so, you know, sure. You can check that out. But it's mainly focused on Zelda. They've done a little bit of Pokemon Sun and Moon, but I'll catch up on that right at the very end of this. But we're here to talk about the press conferences, the conventional press conferences that took place. And we're going to do Microsoft, Ubisoft, and then Sony. They capped it off last night in the early hours for the UK. So let's start off with Microsoft.
Yeah.
And again, we're not doing this. This is not order of the press conference. This one is order of importance, really, or news. Now, Xbox One S announced.
Thinks it's an iPhone.
Yeah, it does. It sounds like it's essentially that's a slim version of the Xbox One, and it does need slimming down.
Yeah,
we've both got one. It is ginormous. Coming in August.
August.
So not too far away from that. We'll have 4K. Output for media, so if you've got Netflix, the likes of that, you can output it on 4K if you have a television that's able to do that. So they do that and you think, okay, fine, you know, that's the standard thing to be doing. People will be interested in that, you know. It's something that if people haven't already got one, or maybe someone wanted to upgrade. I think it's not as big a deal as it was on the 360 because that Red Ring of Death.
Yeah,
because that was rampant, wasn't it?
Oh.
So people were actively trying to get the elite version, or, you know, the slim version when they arrived, because the original models were just sickeningly poor. Mine never broke.
Really?
Somehow, mine never broke, and I had it for absolutely years. I had two, in fact. I've done this story before. I swapped one with Dave. He got a new one. He took my old one. Bit of a dodgy backdoor shady deals going on there, greasing of some palms. But I end up with two, like a newer one, about 4 years in, and neither of them broke. And my first one was probably only about a year or so after it launched, so one of the early ones, because I know some people had some real stinkers of it. So
mate, I had seven.
Really?
I reckon I had seven, and then I bought an Elite.
Wow.
I just kept taking it back, but I never bought seven.
No, of course not.
But I went, it was when the Game Station was still around.
Wow. Did the Elite solve that issue?
It did, yeah. I've still got my last ever one that could still, but I never use it, but it could still have the Ring of Death on it, but I've still got my Elite as well.
Yeah.
And that did solve the issue, yeah. Didn't they just take the red ring out?
Probably, yeah. It's to do with the bloody welding, wasn't it? But cost them a shitload of money as well, because they had to replace them free. So, yeah, the back then it was, you know, you kind of wanted the newer model because you didn't want to run the risk of it crapping out on you.
No.
So, not sure how many people will upgrade to a slim version. And I've definitely... and I'm not sure how many people will buy one out the gate, even though it's coming in at a reason. I think it's $299, so that'd be about 250 quid here. That's very cheap.
That is
a steal.
That is pretty good, but not as cheap as one I bought mine.
No. But it's I think, okay, fine.
Yeah.
That makes sense. That's what's happening.
Yeah.
Then Xbox One Scorpio
is
officially announced, and that negates the need for people that are thinking of buying an Xbox One but don't desperately need one. Want to upgrade to an S, because now there's no point, really, unless you're desperate for 4K. If you're desperate for a smaller version, you need an entertainment space, then, you know, you'd get it. But other than those two reasons, you're not going to get the S. You're going to think, right, I'll wait a year, holidays 2017, for the Scorpio, which they're saying is going to be the most powerful console ever.
Ever.
Huge news. I mean, we expected all this coming, and there were rumours around Sony doing it and whatnot. But I think they pitched it really well.
Yeah.
They mentioned the little montage they did with people talking. I quite like that. And then
getting the developers in.
get them in, get them on board, and tell them what they can do with it. Was it fucking teraflops of damage?
Yeah, I can't remember. Was it 6 or 7 teraflops? But that is, sounds like a fucking beast. If, like, well, it will be what that is. But yeah, once that comes out, and they're saying that you can get proper native 4K gaming on it, and then the frame rates are going to be fine. It won't be impacted by these performances. So, oh.
But the key message that they try to drive home at the end was, no one will get left behind. It's like it's one big family. You've got the Xbox One. If you've got the Xbox One S or the Xbox Scorpio, you can still play the same game. It's what they're saying. Now, I believe that for about 2 years until the developers then think, right, look at all this power we've got here. Let's just push it as far as that can go. Yeah. And then the games just surely won't run in a decent state on the old game. I just can't see how they can continue this side of it being one family.
Well, isn't it, I think it's this year or the last one with Call of Duty, they've binned off the old gen now.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Really. So it's just, there's no point, yeah, there's no point of them optimising the game to run on that low tech when they've got all this fun that they can just smash the shit out of it and get a brilliant game.
Yeah, I don't know, it's a...
See that?
It will be, it's a weird one. It's completely changed the way consoles work now. Because, you know, Sony will be doing something very, very similar, I'm sure, in the next couple of months or whatever. But it's the traditional cycle for these two, Microsoft and Sony, looks like it's coming to an end. Nintendo do whatever they like, so we don't have to, they literally do whatever they want.
They do.
Which I do admire sometimes. But it's big news, and I don't know how it's going to be received. And there's people out there going, oh, how much is it going to be? We don't know. The thing is, it's a long way away to announce this, like a whole year away to give us these sort of details. I was kind of expecting it to be a bit sooner than this because you're looking at like November 2017. That's what, 18 months away?
Yeah. I'm wondering what they're going to do with the games that are currently out now. Are they going to do upgraded versions of them?
Well, the way I envisioned it working, and this is where I think people trip over and get a bit carried away. Like I do sometimes. And I think, oh, it's not going to work, is it? It's how they're going to make it work. But you look, I've got a PC here. You've got a PC there. Maybe not my PC. This is a hunk of shit, poor thing. But I've got an average rig, below average rig. I can still put in, you know, a game and play it on low settings.
Yeah.
And it'll run fine. It's just I can't play things on ultra.
Yeah.
So I don't, and you don't really typically see developers struggle to make the game work properly on those kind of differences. They work seamlessly, it seems. Like if you choose the right setting of graphic fidelity, then it will run well on your machine. So I just envisage it working like that. It's just that the Scorpios and the Neos of the world will look and run better if the graphics will be at, say, a high level rather than a medium level. And then the older versions will be medium. And then as the games get better, a low setting.
Yeah.
Because it happens now, doesn't it? Like they have to develop games for all sorts of different combinations and things for PCs. Graphics cards, GPU, memory. There's so many variables in a PC, and yet, typically, it does work as long as you pick the right settings for your PC.
Yeah.
That is what I'm saying.
Yeah, I can see that. I reckon you're on the right ballpark there.
I think, Sony obviously came up before this, and this will be the last time we mention the Neo as part of this, because it does tie in well. And this is Andrew House come out and said, we're not going to be mentioning the Neo at E3. Mm. I think they're just seeing how this is going down.
Yeah.
They're very smart about this. They've done this when they first launched the consoles or first announced the consoles. Microsoft go first, go on about DRM, entertainment box. Sony then adjust the press conference slightly because apparently they were all signed up to do DRM, like no sharing, all that sort of bollocks. Saw how badly Microsoft got shit on, made the change, put out that little video. They're like, it's recording someone's phone of them handing a game to, going, this is how we share. And just passing the game to him, and completely and utterly done a 180 and made Microsoft look like a bunch of fools. So I sometimes wonder whether Sony just let Microsoft do things just as a guinea pig.
Yeah.
Sit back. If this gets like heavily criticised, and you can see them maybe going, maybe we'll adjust how we do that. But they both seem intent on doing it.
Yeah.
The PC owners, if you've got a good PC, is of absolute irrelevance to you. But for someone like you,
yeah,
you're sort of in a halfway house because you You said you were going to get a PC to never have to bother with consoles.
Yeah.
Now I've ended suck up it back in and then both the bastards.
Yeah, so I reckon this will suck them in as well.
Mm.
I'll like days before or weeks before it comes out, I'll buy myself, I'll upgrade my PC so it's 4K ready. Then that bad boy will come out. So I don't need it, mate. Go forward.
Yeah.
4K PC. 3 weeks later, I go, well, I can't play Uncharted 4K, can
no.
I?
No.
Better get one. Them fucking exclusives get me.
Yeah, well, the thing is, and look, and we move on to that's a good transition there. We look on to what Microsoft are doing, and they were, this is before, we've got a few things before we even get into the games. They mentioned a lot of stuff about the service and whatnot. They were really championing this Play Anywhere system, which essentially means that Microsoft exclusives, they're not Xbox exclusives anymore because they're on Windows 10. Microsoft exclusive, you buy the digital version of those, you can play on your Xbox One or your Windows 10 PC or laptop or whatever you've got, and you'll only be charged once for it. You'll be charged over the odds that first time, you know, a clean sort of £50 or £55 day one, but it means you can sync up save points and you can play with others as well. Cross play looks like it's a big thing with these games, that you can actually search. I could search you out whilst you're on your Windows PC on my Xbox One and find you, which is a big plus. So times are changing, and the way that Microsoft are dealing with their exclusives are that they're now no longer console specific. They are, you know, they're Windows exclusive. So you've got two choices there, which kind of wonder why they're doing the Scorpio still. But the fact is, people aren't comfortable with buying a PC just for gaming. I think it's still out there. I mean, look how many, what, there's 20 million Xboxes, 12 million Wii U's, and 50 million PlayStations. And probably about, you know, obviously a lot of them will have PCs as well, but it's still a massive market for people that just don't want to know.
No, you're right there.
I'm glad they've done this, though, because I was kind of a bit scared that Microsoft were trying to slowly exit.
It did seem like they were sort of trying to hope not to shoot themselves in the foot, but
yeah,
with all these games that are coming out and they're saying, oh, we're now bringing it, like Forza they've brought to PC, haven't they? It was a weird system that they're doing, but now you see the bigger picture, this integration, Play Anywhere they call it.
Exactly, so it's good that they're still going to be producing consoles, because the last thing you want really is, well, as Sony may have done, is what people think. You don't want them just being the only ones in the market, because they'll just slack off. You've got to have competition there. Last little piece before we get into the games. They've added this thing called Clubs, which is basically, which I think is community. So we could add a DIMP digital community on Xbox One, similar to what PS4's got now, in communities and groups, that sort of thing. So,
yeah.
And there's this weird, weird thing where you can put an advert in for playing matchmaking, essentially. You can say, oh, I want to play Destiny, you want to do this raid, and it sort of sends a communication out to people that are in that arena, and then you can join and link up with them.
That's what it's called, isn't it? Arenas.
Yeah, that's it, arenas, which are confusing, because that's a think of arena shooters, and it's come on, here's some new words in the industry. Right. That's all the bollocks dealt with. Get into the games. Gears of War 4, bang, gameplay demo.
Done.
Looked
kicked
good.
It off. Yeah, it did. Yeah.
Looked very good. And big, big news. They didn't actually show us this or go into any detail. They might do later on this week, but Horde Mode 3.0.
Yeah, it was a surprise to see that.
Because I was under the impression there'd been that.
Yeah, I think you'd said that, and I got that into my head that we weren't getting it, and I thought, because there's this little niggle about this game for some reason in my head. After playing the beta, there is this little niggle, and I think the sour taste of Judgment.
Yeah.
And, you know, Cliff leaving an epic and whatnot. It's a bit like, I want to be real hyped for this game, but there's something holding me back.
Yeah.
But this was good. Yeah, seeing that gameplay,
look,
it does look brilliant, this game. It looks fantastic, sounds good. It looks like it's got these big action set pieces in, which are cool, which is to very good as a war.
Yeah.
And now the inclusion confirmed, Horde Mode 3.0, which is what we want from a Gears game.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I was surprised that they hadn't... It's come to this point and they've only just announced it. I don't know whether, again, it's come from feedback or whatever, but there was a time after the beta where I just thought, I've got 1% interest in this.
Yeah.
Horde mode now gives me a chance, gives it a much bigger chance of purchasing, simply because I just think that mode's brilliant. And I love a bit of horde mode. It's as simple as that.
Yeah, it's fucking brilliant. Will you buy the wireless controller?
Oh, the limited edition.
Elite,
no.
Not a chance.
I'll tell you what, if Hall will be listening, he claims to be that he goes, I fucking love Gears. That's his little comment. It's about voice, that's not his voice. It's more whiny than that. But
I no, fucking love Gears.
That's spot on. He goes, I fucking love Gears. Well, if you fucking love Gears, then go and get the Elite controller, even though you've already got an Elite. Get the Gears of War edition, then we'll see how much you fucking love Gears then, won't we? There's the challenge. Laid it down, poor bastard. But that's still coming out for October the 11th, Gears of War 4, so we will see that later on this year. Oh. But definitely a thumbs up from what I saw. Go on, sorry.
Seeing Marcus Fenix as well.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's an old bastard now, isn't he?
Was it 20 years afterwards, is it?
Yeah.
Poor old son. I was hoping they wouldn't bother with all... I knew as soon as they mentioned his son.
Yeah.
It's happening.
Popping in. Yeah. Say hello.
He will say hello. He'll probably die in it or something. Hello. Spoilers! Don't know anything about. I haven't written it. But...
I ain't written it, mate. Have you?
No, I haven't. Should do. Yeah, it'd probably be better. No. Forza Horizon 3. Australia. Yep. Looks quite cool, actually. I mean, I know Logan got Forza Horizon 2, but I think Australia is quite a good place to set that because it's obviously big open outbacks. It's quite a lot of different environments they can go through there.
Yeah, it had a little bit of a motor storm. I don't know if you ever played that.
Yeah, no, I remember
PlayStation exclusive.
Yeah, that was game, when they first announced it, it looked like the best thing I'd ever seen, and unfortunately, that was Evolution Studios who did Drive Club, I think. So
was it?
Interesting. Two real blowers in their time.
Yeah. But no, it did look pretty cool.
I liked it. I liked the look of this.
The trailer that they done where they had the four different type of players.
That was the Play Anywhere as well, wasn't it? You had a guy that was on PC, you had a guy that was on Xbox One, another guy that was on...
The new Xbox.
Another guy that was on Scorpio. No Scorpio. But there was, and they were all on different devices and they could sync up and it looked like... I mean, if it all works like that, that's
great. Yeah.
That's great.
Well, they were saying about a one-touch button to link up.
Yeah, that's the sort of thing that worries me, only because my finger might slip.
Yeah.
Be that easy.
End up with a couple of Russians.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, chaps.
Pick me up after the Euros. I'm like, oh, what's going on?
What's going on here?
Oh, that's a good direction for Forza Horizon 3. Then they're solid entries, and you know, it's a series that appeals to me a lot more than the other settings. Australia.
Mm.
Really like the look of that. Thumbs up for that one. Recore. Bit more information. Got a trailer. Yeah. I must say, I didn't enjoy the trailer very much. It looked a little bit a bit loud and annoying almost. I was like, wow, I didn't expect it to be like this. I thought it was going to be quite relaxed or serious, but no, it looked like it was a bit, it was nice and light-hearted, but sure if I'm gonna be,
it's got a bit of certain meh to it.
Yeah.
Meh out of 10 I'll give it.
That was a tricky, I mean, we hadn't heard anything in a year. And then they dropped that, and I was like, well, is that what is required?
Yeah.
This level.
We need a game like that.
In the people behind it, it's got Inafone behind it, and also some of the guys that worked on Metroid Prime, which all loves to. So it's got the people doing it.
Need to see more. I'll have to watch the trailer again, but I didn't really take much away from it.
It was a load of old bollocks. You wouldn't know what was going on.
Yeah.
Really. But it's scheduled to release this year in September. So September the 13th we've got listed at the moment. So it's not even far away at all. But I need to see some gameplay of that properly, I think. Big one for you next.
Yeah.
Final Fantasy 15.
Take it away, Mutt.
It's a live demo. Mm-hmm. And, okay, fine. I know they can go wrong. It can go wrong because all sorts of shit can happen, but when it first started up, it's this big boss, isn't it? It's massive, great big awesome looking boss. Honestly, I was like, wow, the scale of this guy looks amazing. But watching the poor fucker trying to play it,
mate, he was dog shit, wasn't he, Mutt?
He fucking built half of it.
I know, he's a developer, he can't even play it. I wasn't watching the game, I was watching his health bar to see if he was actually going to die.
I think actually at one point all the party died and it must have had a setting.
I wonder if they did, just to save embarrassment on that, I do wonder if they insert like a god mode on these
E3
trailers. Go, because imagine that, dying in a demo. But yeah, that is exactly the same thing went through my head as I watched it. I thought, he's fucking dog shit. at this.
Poor bastard. I mean, I couldn't think of anything worse than having to go up there and do that, because you can play it a million times in a room when no one's around you, but then you've got to fucking go outside on this big hot stage and there's fucking light shining in your eyes. Mm. I can see why it was a struggle, but seeing the game in motion, you might have a different opinion. I was not.
No, I've got to say, it didn't give the combat. That's what it was focusing on, the combat. Yeah, because he was so shit on it, it just looked all over the place. Yeah. I wonder if it's done professionally or like and slowed down. He was just like running into the bloke's arm and stuff.
Yeah.
It just really wasn't a great demo for it, was it?
No, it made it look really bad. And the fact, and again, it's another September one. There's not long left, and it's a worry. That's a worry for me, considering how long it's been in bloody development ball. How much they? It's been like 10-11 years, isn't it?
Yeah. 10 years since they first announced it, and then
insane budget, and just seeing it like that. Yeah. Again, was it the player that made it look worse? Perhaps.
I think so. Yeah, but.
Well, yeah, I mentioned on the last one, I didn't like the.
Did you? I like that. I do. See, that's the thing. I think if it's played properly, you could probably work it around, and you'll start to get used to it. But that trailer did not do no justice whatsoever.
That is a disaster almost, I think, because people will see that and go, what the fuck?
Yeah, well, that's it. When this is your biggest stage and you've got to sell this combat, get a fucking player who can play it.
I feel sorry for him, but that is what happens. Then Microsoft decided to bung in a couple of trailers. So the Division DLC, Underground. Yeah. We'll talk about that in the Ubisoft one because they went into a bit more detail there. And also Battlefield 1, that popped up again. It's like, okay, I understand why EA do that, because probably more people watching Microsoft than Sony's one. You want to be on one of those, really, if you can.
Yeah.
I don't understand Microsoft, what they're getting out of that.
No, did they announce anything? Like sometimes they get DLC first or... Oh, yeah, they did. Didn't they... Oh, no.
There's a few things like that, but I don't think Battlefield had anything announced yet, so...
Yeah, just shutting the trailer again.
Yeah, I was like, okay.
Thanks.
I'm going to have a piss now, I think, while that's on. Microsoft Realms. So that is,
Minecraft Realms, you mean?
What do I say? Microsoft?
Microsoft. He's got Microsoft on the brain.
Yeah, that's the trouble with these. They're very similar. But yeah, Minecraft Realms, sorry. So
and these are the winners... of the most
cringeworthy,
each conference, there's at least one section where you think, oh my god, and these were the winner, the woman in particular. Yeah.
It was, let's explain what they were trying to show. It's very similar to this Play Anywhere, but with Minecraft, they're bringing together not just like Windows and Xbox One, but Apple and Android devices, so tablets, phones. You can now play Minecraft with your friends across all these platforms. Amazing. You know,
yeah, pretty cool.
Great to see. So what they did is, again, similar to the Forza demo, they had a load of four people playing on different things. One guy playing on Oculus, wasn't he? One of the Oculus guys was there.
Yeah, well, that's I'm half tempted to buy that after seeing this, because I can get it on my phone, the Gear VR.
Oh, we've got Gear VR, so you could. So that means there must be a way, once Minecraft Realms drops, that you can then play on Gear VR...
Yep.
And play me on my Xbox One version of it.
Yeah.
We should give that a try.
We should. I could be that little annoying bloke in the corner going, look at this, guys. It looks great.
Moving on to what actually occurred, it was the cringe moment of 2016. Oh. No doubt about it. It was just some of the things they were coming out with. It's so forced and awkward. I was like, I might have to switch it off.
Yeah.
I might have to, but... It's hilarious. If you want to watch it, it's just so hilariously bad. And
she was so happy, bless her.
Yeah, I mean, Minecraft is good. I love Minecraft. Yeah, I think it's amazing, but come on. I understand why they do this, because obviously they bought Minecraft, and it's fucking huge. So you want to give it the airtime it needs, and fair enough, they did that. They went out and did that. Yeah. Then they had a little section, they moved on to like ID, is it ID Xbox?
Oh yeah, that's their sort of announcement, what EA started to do when it was their announcement the other day.
Hold on.
Just gonna find out what it's called. EA Originals, and that's then you've got the Ubisoft one. Yeah, I think ID Xbox is their sort of version of this.
Yeah, and we had the
kind of.
Yeah, the guy that heads up that came out and was talking about a game coming out very shortly called Inside. He went on to say it's one of the best games he's ever played, and it's a masterpiece.
From the people that made Limbo.
Yes, now that's free.
Yeah.
So if you've got an Xbox One,
And Xbox Gold.
And Xbox Gold, yes. Of course. Then you can go and download that now for free. I'm sure it's been on PlayStation Plus.
Oh, is it?
I think so. I remember I've got it somewhere. And one of the I've got it on my PC, which I bought, and then I've also got it on a console somewhere. But right. There's so many of these games, I get fucking confused. It's like, yeah, Playdead are doing Inside, and he's banging on about that, saying it's coming. It's June 29th, so it's only a couple of weeks away. And wow. I know it was probably bollocks.
Greatest game he's ever played.
I know it was bollocks what he said. But I want to play it just because he said it.
Just for that, yeah. It's just so you can find him on Twitter after and go, you liar!
Oh, yeah, that is one part of it. I do like a moan, so that's definitely something that I'll look at. But it'll be arriving on Xbox One on June the 29th, and I'm going to have a look at it for sure just because of that. I mean, that is a bold statement, but we'll see how it goes. We then got a demo of We Happy Few.
Oh,
now.
Brilliant.
This looks fantastic. Yeah, I agree. It is BioShock is what I thought.
Instantly. Yeah.
Yeah, I really like the look of this. It looks really fucked up. What's going on? So essentially, from what I could gather from the trailer, the demo, is there's a load of people. There's a society that lives. It looks like it's underground somewhere. I don't know. It's all nice, like built up. It's not like mud and shit, but it's a community living there, and they take drugs. They're made to take drugs and pills to keep them positive, to keep them happy. And one of the side effects of not taking the drugs is that they see what is actually going on around them. So the main example I saw in this was what are those things called at the birthdays? Pinata, is it?
Pinata, yeah.
A pinata. So they're all around the table hitting a pinata going, oh, it's fun, it's going to give us food. The guy that you're playing, he stopped taking his happy pills. He's binned them off. Mm. And he then hits the pinata and he snaps out of the reality that they live in, having those pills. And it's like a rat, isn't it, or something? Like a horrible rat that he's just smashed and then they're eating the rat. So what it's doing, these pills are obviously covering up what is really going on there, and then after that they're like, oh, he's a downer, he's going, which I guess means you're coming off the pills, and then it all kicks off. So that it looked amazing.
Yeah, it's fucking a brilliant concept, really cool.
Looks a bit freaky though, I'm not sure I can.
Oh, it does, yeah. It has got that sort of weird BioShock feel, but it just looks like BioShock on drugs.
Yeah. I'm happy to have a good look at that. I think it's on the Xbox One preview program as well. So if you guys have got that, you fancy putting your money down, it's there for people to try and play whilst it's in an early state.
Is that a new thing, that Xbox preview thing? Early access. Sorry.
Yeah, I mean, it's early access essentially on it. It's been around, I think, since last year.
Is it?
So autumn last year, yeah.
Gone past me, that is.
Well, the thing is, it's not like Steam where there'll be £8 after.
Right.
It's, you know, I've not used it.
Right.
I'm not a big fan of doing it.
Yeah.
Really, but it's there if people want it. Like Xbox Preview, it's called. And yeah, there's early access games on there that you can give your feedback on. We then had CD Projekt Red pop out, and I was thinking, yes.
Here we go.
Cyberpunk. Get it. And no, it was the Witcher Gwent card game.
Fucking hell.
I mean, again, Microsoft.
No, you liked it, didn't you?
I mean, I like it, but they didn't say whether it was coming out on mobile devices still. It's going, you can play it on your Xbox One. I was like, I'm not sitting there doing that. I ain't doing it. Put it on mobile, please. But again, a weird one for Microsoft to put in.
Yeah, very strange. I did think that. I don't know what their allegiance was there.
9 minutes as well. It weren't like it was a short amount of time, but yeah, that's coming. We all knew that was coming. It's when they say September, was it? It's dropping
something like that. Yeah, it was quite late in the year, wasn't it? It's the trailer that got me. All the people dressed up as Witcher and things.
Yeah. It does look. I mean, it's Gwent. If you've played it, it's a good game. But I'm not sure I'd be sitting on a console sitting there playing that. Tekken 7.
Tekken, yes. Brilliant. Yeah, I really like this. The inclusion of Akuma is brilliant as a Street Fighter fan. But yeah, it's the way the story mode that they showed, didn't they?
Oh, yeah, they look good.
Yeah, the sort of you can have sort of in-game, like in the middle of the fights, you sort of have a little bit of a buff and add a few little slow-mos. And it's also 3D as well. You're not sort of just that it's not a 2D fighter anymore. It's 3D.
Yeah, you can go around them, can't you? Yeah.
Yeah, I like how the stage around was destructed as well, and you can sort of, the stages are in different parts, so if you knock a moat off to the edge, you can fall into the next part of the level.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is Tekken, it is what it is, but I'm hyped.
Hyped for that one then, because you've had a bit of a stinker with old Street Fighter, this lack of content, you hope to repair that.
Yeah, that's supposed to be coming out this month, actually. I think they announced that the other day.
Yeah.
They're having a story mode, a proper one. But, yeah, it's been a bit of a stinker. So can Tekken outdo the boys at Capcom?
Yeah, has it been a while since the last Tekken game? It feels like. I've not seen a new one for a long while.
We had Tekken 6, didn't we, on that? It was Xbox. And then, yeah, which was announced as a free game because of Tekken 2. We had Tekken Tag Tournament 2.
Well, yeah, backwards compatibility, yeah.
That's it. That came out in 2012. So that was 4 years ago.
All right.
So, yeah, it has been a long while. So that's probably your last game.
Yeah.
They had the Street Fighter cross Tekken game that was poor, apparently. but that's all we've had from the Tekken boys. So it has been a long while since, you know, their main series has been, cool, must have been getting on 6-7 years, I reckon.
Yeah, okay. Fair enough. It's been long enough then.
Yeah.
Frank is back.
He is.
Dead Rising 4.
Christmas.
It was Christmas, wasn't it? They were bigging that up. So that's coming this year as well. So
imagine. That is, yeah, holiday season, wasn't it? They keep saying.
Yeah, 2016 for that. So it didn't really get a great load of details. And I've seen since then, obviously now people have had demos of it. And during this week, you know, obviously we're only, only talking about what happened in the press conference. During the week, there's obviously the floor is now open for people that are there, the media and whatnot on the outlet. So there's going to be interviews, previews and all sorts of details coming out that's going to clarify a lot of what we're talking about here. But Dead Rising 4 confirmed, doesn't look like a reboot or a remake. It looks like a fourth entry into it.
It didn't really show, like, what you saw is just sort of additions. It, like, obviously it's been updated by graphics and, you know, how many more zombies you can get on the screen, but it didn't show any new sort of mechanics of what you could do. The only thing you could do is, like, take a selfie with zombies, but just more improved weapons. Just bigger and better, I suppose. But I suppose they say if it ain't broken, don't fix it.
Yeah, I mean, I was getting sick of Dead Rising 3 was a real trouble that was for me to get through. I got through it, but I struggled back towards the end of that, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to tolerate it.
It must be selling well for them to put out a fourth in such...
True. Yeah. I mean, that is a good point. They're not going to be just chucking money away, but...
People love zombies, don't they?
Yeah, it's always going to be there for the next 10, 15 years. Damn you, Walking Dead!
they got them to thank.
I've only gone and done it. I don't mind zombies, actually.
Good old zombies.
Scalebound.
Yes.
Got to look at a co-op demo. So there's a boss fight. So this is how Final Fantasy's boss fight should have gone.
Yeah. Amen to that.
Yeah, so Scalebound, obviously you have your dragon that you can use to jump on and fly and mix up your combat techniques. But it looked like other people could join and you could do these bosses cooperatively.
Yeah.
Which I think could be really cool. If it works the way it should work. It looked decent.
Yeah, it looked cool. The scale of it was very God of War. These over-the-top massive bosses looking awesome.
Yeah. I'll tell you what I'm not convinced with. I wasn't overly convinced with the gameplay. It looked a little bit awkward, but, you know, whatever. It's tough to see sometimes with the fucking stream and the way it's compressed on YouTube. You're never going to get a crystal clear look at things. But the one thing that I took away that was a negative was that I really think the main character's a dickhead.
Yeah, he's got a bit of, do you know, the Devil May Cry? There was the reboot.
And didn't they make him a right cock in it?
Yeah, and it's very similar to him, and he's sort of like this, this sort of cocky middle-aged kid, not middle-aged, teenage.
Middle-aged
50 years old killing dragons.
Grow up, mate, go home. After your kids.
So, it did have that same sort of thing, but that is, I guess, a similar thing. I thought he's annoying. He could get annoying.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, it's not due to 2017. It's got a long way to go, but it's good to see it again, check in on it. Good to there's looking like some co-op elements to it, so I'm always excited to see that sort of things. Another game that looks like it's going to have lots of co-op elements and something that's really excited me after seeing this is Sea of Thieves. Looks like a super fun game, doesn't it?
It does. Yeah, it's what we've wanted. We've been saying that we wanted a decent pirate game after Black Flag.
Yeah. I mean, they committed the usual sin of just putting a clearly scripted, like, load of players in there to make lines up. But it's fine. But it shows, you know, elements of the game that you can just fuck about and you can all go together, get on a boat, and to get the boat moving, you've got to work together as a team, drop the sails, twist the thing around, get everything moving, and then once you're out at sea, you know, you're a pirate.
You're a pirate. You can drink and get drunk.
Yeah.
You can sing. You can. I really like when they blew a hole in the side of the ship, and then you've got to patch that hole up and, get flooded. Oh, it's fucking awesome, this game.
The naval combat looks really good.
Yeah.
Really, really good. I was really impressed with this, and it's one that I'm earmarking. I want to see lots more about this. I want to get a release date, and I want to start getting excited for that. Only question mark, obviously, is, as with these games, you can't play that on your own.
No, it looks like it's going to be one of those ones that we need committees.
Which we know it's not always easy in this life.
Tough. On the Xbox as well.
Xbox is letting the side down. That's what people are saying. I mean, I'm on both sides of the fence, but within the dimp quarters, there's definitely a lack of Xbox profile, should we say.
Yeah. We need new members.
Yeah, we do. That's not an open invitation to people listening. I don't want to speak to you.
No.
I love you all, but I don't want to, you know, come on. I get annoyed with the amount of people I've got on my friends list already. And not because I've got loads, although I've got a few, but it's just, you know, those people I've had to delete, and I know them. So you guys have got no chance. Only another concern with Sea of Thieves, will it actually work? Because it sounds like it's going to be very online focused, and this is not something Rare, to my knowledge, have done on this scale.
Definitely. This has got to be their biggest game they've ever done. Well, they did that Perfect Dark, but this has got to be the biggest one.
Oh, it looks, because it looks like it's an almost like an MMO or a.
It's
not like, maybe not.
No, yeah. I know what you mean.
It's a persistent world that people will drop in and could be anywhere on the map, and you could randomly encounter people. What I'd like to see in this, actually, if there was an area of the map where that was co-op only. And then it's like the Dark Zone almost in The Division, where you could go out to like uncharted seas. That's where other players are knocking around, and you're likely to get in trouble. Because I can see it becoming a frustration if you're stuck on a team that's not very good and you get attacked every 5 minutes and you sink, your ship gets sunk. That's my only concern. State of Decay 2, that then drops. That was one of their smaller games that actually done quite well. Microsoft.
Yeah.
I quite liked State of Decay. I had it on PC in the end, and I really enjoyed it. It was one of those, is that time of gaming where DayZ was very good, very popular, sorry.
Yeah.
And that whole zombie survival thing was good. But the thing with DayZ was, A, it was a mod and it was very janky. Like, it still looks a mess now. I can't believe it's still in alpha. It's absurd. It's absurd. But this then come along, and it seemed like a little bit more of a polished version. It turns out it's a bit janky as well. But the key was, there weren't dickheads killing you every 5 minutes because it was offline. Mm. So you build up your own kind of stable of people and build up your own settlement within like an offline community that you could just play against the AI, which I enjoyed thoroughly. It had a story mode as well. And I really did enjoy this. My PC struggled to run it, but I still, you know, soldiered on and got through it all. So I'm quite pumped up to see if this is going to get a sequel. It was one of my, you know, if you're going to look at a survival zombie type games, it's probably my favourite. And I've played some toilet, including War Z, which was absolute disgraceful. It was only £8, but worst £8 I've ever spent. got it in early access, didn't I? I got really suckered in by it all.
You did.
I'll go through the story one day, but I got really suckered into that whole scene, and it's just a mistake. Really put me off doing anything like that before. But the only thing I'd like to see at a State of Decay 2 would be co-op. Online co-op. And it did say in the trailer, it was alluding to, you know, you can't survive alone. There's like a guy that gets trapped and he fires up a flare, and then the people that are at the gas station look up and it looks like they're going to go over and help him out. So I'm wondering if that's what they're trying to allude to.
Very possible. Was the first one not online then at all?
It was all offline.
Interesting.
Because I initially thought it was going to be at least co-op, and I found out it was offline. I was like, that's a bit annoying. But to be honest, in the end, I didn't notice at all. So to see the second one do that, I would be very, very interested.
Yeah,
I'd be interested anyway. It struggled a little bit in terms of its graphics and its performance. It was a bit of a pig.
Yep.
And they released a year one edition, I believe, on Xbox One. It sorted a lot of those problems. But other than that, I've not really got much bad to say about it. I enjoyed it. And it didn't get the best reviews. Got sort of sitting at like a 70, 75. But I enjoyed it for what it was. And to see a sequel that's coming next year, I think they've put on that. So, look, I'll be watching that one for sure. Then they close out the press conference with Halo Wars 2. We knew this was going to happen.
Yeah.
You knew this is gonna. This is all rumored. Bang! It's out there for those that like it. Excellent. You can look forward to Halo Wars 2 coming later on this year. But that was the end of the press conference, and then at the end of it, I was like, "That's quite good."
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, I think they might have ended on Scorpio. Actually, correct me.
Yeah, they did actually. Yeah.
So game wise, at the last game, they did end on Scorpio. We'd already spoken about it, but and at the end of that, and I was like, "Okay, they've done quite a lot there."
Mm.
But none of it was. There was no surprises.
No, I thought that. I think
Forza, I knew all this was happening.
Yeah, Forza was the only sort of surprise, really.
I knew that. I could have told you that last year. That's because next year, you know what happened? There'll be Forza 7, the main.
Yeah, that's very true.
Do it every other year, it seems, or every year.
Dead Rising 4 so would have been a sort of surprise, but that was leaked as well.
That's a bit cruel taking that one away from them.
And the Slim, I suppose. That was leaked a couple of days before, but again, people knew that was coming.
Yeah, I think it's just, they seem to be in a little bit of a rut with the same franchise being wheeled out.
Yeah.
Every year. Dead Rising's become part of that.
Mm.
Obviously, they can't go a year without any sort of Halo, so you've got Halo Wars, you know, dropping this year. I don't know.
I'm surprised as well.
It's like they're the ones. I want them to branch off and do something completely new.
Yeah, they've not. That's the thing. PlayStation, every year they always come out with these big brand new IPs, like big budget IPs, but they don't seem to do that, Microsoft. They sort of stick with their guns. You can really tell that they're pumping all their hope into Gears of War 4.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely, I was really down on Gears of War 4, but it's definitely pulled me up and out of it. We had noticeable absentees like Crackdown 3. That's been delayed also into 2017. That's one of the things that's come out from the show floor in the last day or so. So that didn't make an appearance I was expecting. That's obviously having some trouble. But yeah, Microsoft's press conference, I think it was a decent effort. It was about an hour and a half long. It's a little bit on the long side for me. But if you're going to grade it out of 10, what would you be giving?
God, I can't even remember. What was my scores from yesterday? I give something about 5.5, didn't I?
Six,
that's Bethesda, wasn't it? 6.5 and 5.5. The games look good. Yeah, I'm just going through the list again. And the console. So I'm going to give this a 7.
I will also go with a 7, which draws level with Bethesda on my one.
Oh.
The only thing it was good. There's a bit of waffling.
Yeah,
my taste, but
the console announcements really did up it for me, especially with that Scorpio. You know, I thought that was just rumours. I weren't expecting a big announcement like that, and to see it official, that was a bit like fuck. Yeah. Shit, they mean business.
They mean business, and big. It's always good to see Big Phil out there doing his thing.
Yeah,
I mentioned a bit of waffle in Microsoft, but that was nothing compared to Ubisoft, which is now where we come on to. I mean, we'll talk about that afterwards, but it kicks off with Just Dance. Just Dance 2017. They must know they're taking the piss with this. There's a load of fucking people out there dancing, prancing around. But it was absurd. But they came out and they kick off the press conference straight in. And that is actually Just Dance 2017. They said it's coming on NX.
Who's fucking buying these games?
Don't know. You wonder where they must like to just waste money sometimes, and that's got to be part of it. That's absurd, but it's coming out. There's people out there. There must be a market for it.
It must probably fucking be selling well, but
yeah,
Christ. Things like Guitar Hero, that's all dead and buried now. That was awesome. How the fuck is this still surviving, Just Dance?
There's always a market for people dancing. That's what we can say. They kick off with Ghost Recon properly.
That's it.
So we get a CG trailer and then get a gameplay demo.
Yeah.
What were your thoughts on this demo?
On the demo?
Yeah, what the gameplay we saw.
I thought it looked fucking awesome.
It did
look cool. I like how it reminded me of a cooperative Metal Gear Solid 5. I really did.
I thought that as well.
I like the stealth elements and things. A couple of things that annoyed me though is he's like, oh, let's do some stealth elements, and he just shot his gun, and a couple of times he had a silencer on, but sometimes he didn't, and no one alerted to it. I was like, where the fucking realism in here?
I did think that. He's like, let's do it stealth, but maybe he's going to sneak up and choke him. No, he just fires his gun off, and I was like,
yeah.
I don't know what your version of stealth is, but I tell you, the only thing I took away a little bit negative was that it looked a little bit rough. graphically, I wasn't over impressed. It's a long way, it's a little way away, but I like the idea of this. I mean, it seems you look at the Division, that's obviously a cooperative shooter, and this is another take on that, but in a much more open environment. I liked it towards the end when it all kicked off. It was all
that looked cool,
kicking off, and I like the fact it looks like it's going to give people options to tackle things. Again, though, it's going to be relying on having a team of at least two, preferably three or four, I think, is what you want for this. But
ideally,
got my eye on it for sure. I like to do a little gameplay demo and Ghost Recon Wildlands. Tom
Cocaine, the game.
Yeah,
that's what they were selling.
Yeah, they were.
They were glamorising in that first trailer. I was thinking, fucking hell. Like, we're all about the cocaine here at Ubisoft.
Yeah. Maybe someone's had a word in the room and gone, pack doing that, Ian. That's not,
come on, mate.
That's not what we're aiming for. But March the 7th, 2017. I was really hoping for this year, but they love a March release now after the success of The Division. Maybe that's their new... And I'll tell you what, at the end, not the end of this podcast, but on another podcast, I'm going to reconcile all the release dates. And I'll tell you what, Q1 next year looks fucking well busy. Well, already
tasted.
Yeah, between like February and March, God, it's almost like the new Christmas.
Yeah, isn't it?
I don't know what's going on. We then had South Park, The Fractured Butthole.
Still makes me chuckle. Yeah. Fucking awesome.
Yeah, I mean, I'll let you take away this one. I mean, I'll play the first one. But one thing I would say is that if you do pre-order this, it's coming out, December the 6th, I think they said?
Yeah.
You will get the sticker true for free.
Yeah, so which is a nice inclusion.
Pre-order it and cancel it, and this will be my advice. And then
that'd be cool. But no, it does look more. It just looks like they've stuck with the groundwork of the first game. It's got its new setting, obviously. Like the first one we had was set in a sort of fantasy setting.
Yes.
And this one, they're going for the superheroes.
Yeah.
They just introduced a few new moves you could do. They've improved the combat system. Now it was very Final Fantasy turn based in the first one.
Right, yeah.
They've stuck with that, but you also got a bit of movement where you can sort of cover now and things and add a bit on there. So it looks like they've improved on there, but it does still look freaking hilarious, and that's what this game's about. You're still with that. You're the new kid on the block.
Yeah. But, yeah, I mean, it's so true to the TV show, even just the way it looks.
Isn't it? Yeah.
Incredible, really. And yeah, for people that were fans of the first one, they're going to love it. For people that are fans of South Park, they're going to love it. And it's definitely one to put on your radar. And it's coming this year, so that is always a good thing when you
and
get
the winners for funniest stage presence as well.
Matt Stone and Trey Parker there, they were
did you get the I don't know if you didn't get it, they're doing their reference to a South Park episode all about Kanye West.
Yeah, I mean, that's the trouble. This is what I mean when I mentioned the other day about I struggle because I don't have enough knowledge of it, and there's a gap there, so I've probably went over my head, but I still found them funny.
Yeah. They're very cool.
The Division, they won't let that die, so.
No.
Finally announced some expansions, the underground expansion. So it's going to include, it's sort of set under in the sewers, it looks like, the sewer network of it.
Yeah.
And it says it's going to have randomly generated missions.
That'd be interesting. I hope it's not going to be like six and then they just sort of stick a few bits and bobs on.
Yeah, that is the trouble with randomly generated shit, is that tends to happen. So that's coming, not too, as a little way away. June the 28th. That's not far away, actually. Sorry.
That's 2 weeks today.
June the 28th on Xbox and PC. August the 2nd for PlayStation 4.
Ooh.
That's where I meant it was coming for a while.
Right.
So that's one of those, you know, type exclusives they've got. So,
we've got a PS4, haven't we?
Well, mine's been traded a long way away. It's really gone. Well, the thing is, that this expansion is not free. I can guarantee you that.
No, that's true. It's part of the thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Season pass.
Yeah. They then previewed their next expansion, Survival. CGI trailer. No idea what this is.
No.
Just colder weather. I don't know.
Yeah, that's what it was. Just a storm, wasn't it?
It's trying to kind of play out that you've got the survival elements to it. Like you have to eat and I don't know if that's what you have to do. They were suggesting like you've got to hunt for food and the weather can affect you. And I was like, okay, so they're going to introduce new mechanics where you can't stay outside? I don't know. Maybe it's going to be like a hardcore. You know how they do Like survival mode on Fallout.
Fallout, exactly yeah. what I just thought of. Yeah, I wonder if they've, because that's just recently been released, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I wonder if they're going to take a leaf out of that book and have that. But that would be cool, yeah, if they implemented new mechanics, but it'll probably just be put on your gas mask or something when you go outside and you have to drink a chocolate bar,
yeah.
as Logan calls them.
That's it. So that's the Division dealt with. That'll be, that's one of the things that's changed probably in the last few years about games. Everything's supported for like a year now.
Yeah.
I'm going to squeeze every last penny out of each game with people are willing to play it, pay it. So
they're platforms, not games.
Yeah, that's very true.
What they call them, the weirdos. But
yeah, that is it. They do call them platforms.
You yeah, want. Strange.
We had a little bit of VR later then from Ubisoft. So Eagle Flight VR on the Oculus was demoed. Yeah. Like a Capture the Flag demo.
Yeah. It's like set in a Last of Us Paris, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's a bit weird that. Graphically looked like shit.
Yeah, it did look pretty poor. It was just football, wasn't it, with eagles?
Mm, this is, I mean, it did look poor. And then they had the Star Trek VR demo as well. Again, it looked trash graphically. It looked fun, whatever, it's fine, it's VR. But this is why I go back to what we was talking about yesterday with Bethesda, saying that Fallout 4 and Doom are going to go on VR. And then I see this and I think, how? I don't understand how.
Nah, that's one thing I've got to say about the first thoughts on that Gear VR. I bought the resolution on that. It's fucking poor.
Yeah.
So how are they going to get it up to the quality standard of how them games play on next gen and have it on E3? That is going to take some work.
Yeah. But so those were the two bits. They wasted fucking loads of time talking about Star Trek VR. Well, I mean, a lot of people are big fans of it.
Yeah.
If you've got, you know, the money to get this and you love Star Trek, I'm sure you will. Which you control the ship, basically, don't you, with your friends? Like it's like a co-op type game, and then you get into battles and people have to have certain tasks to do. They had one of the guys coming out who I think starring in one of the new movies to sit down and talk about. They all, as part of the promotion, they sat them all down, all the co-stars, and played in this game. There's obviously going, oh, it's amazing.
Oh, yeah, is that Carl Urban? That
That's one? It, yeah, they're all doing that. But, you know, for Star Trek people, then you know, you've had a game for ages that's been worth anything, so hopefully this is something that you and Ubisoft, though, what it suggests to me is that they're willing to dip their toes into VR in, you know, potentially take a few risks with it, because, you know, not a lot of publishers are, you know, got more than one or two projects on the go, and these look like they're gonna they're cashing in on it to have a little look and see how well it does.
Got to be a Assassin's Creed VR coming out soon, surely.
There will be, won't there?
Fuck doing the leap of faith on that.
Oh, yeah, it'd be sick. Unbelievable. For Honor then arrives. That's a darling from last year's E3. Yep. Lots of positive things going on for that.
Yeah, I've got to say, this is one where this is my version of your Gears of War 4. I weren't really hyped about this at all, really. Have you ever played Chivalry on PC?
I don't know.
It's like a sort of similar sort of style of game, a sort of medieval multiplayer game. And I just thought it was just going to be that on console. And I sort of, you know, I looked at it and thought, oh, it looks all right, but very meh. But after watching this, I thought, oh, fucking actually, this looks awesome.
Yeah.
It had a bit of a Rise, Son of Rome feel to it, I thought.
Yeah. It does help that the creative director, Jason Van Der Bella, he's awesome.
He's an absolute boy, isn't he?
Yeah, he's really good with this, selling this game, and just, you can tell his passion. He's just good at delivering all of his lines and getting you interested in it. He does a very good job. But what's, you know, last year it was all about multiplayer. They talked about going one-on-one with other people, and that's going to be the main part of it. So I was surprised, really surprised, to see that they had a campaign. So I was kind of like, whoa, that's good.
Yeah,
I was expecting this to be a multiplayer only. It looked really cool.
Yeah, I've got to say, like I say, we really weren't that bothered about it until I saw this, and I thought, fuck me, that looks rad.
Yeah.
Yep, sign me up.
Sign him up. Well, there is a beta to sign up for that, so definitely jump on Ubisoft if you're interested, and you can try and sign up for that. We had a gameplay demo, and it took us through, you know, some taking on some minions and then some harder enemies and a mini boss, and the release date's tabled for 14th of February 2017. So there you go, another one coming
Q1.
In the early part of next year, and it could be a real clog up. We then had Grow Up, which is a sequel to Grow Home, wasn't it? I put Gone Home down. It's not that. It's a different game.
Gone Home.
But yeah, Grow Home, which I've got, again, through the PlayStation freebies. I haven't played it, really want to because it looks good, so no surprise that this is going to get a sequel. I think it was, you know, people, a lot of people loved it. Trials Blood Dragon.
Seeing them mishmash in their franchise here.
It's out now.
Oh.
It's out now.
I think I was talking about that yesterday. Did I say it'd be wicked if they just announced the game and then they'd release it there and
there?
Yeah, there we go.
They've done Trials of Blood Dragon, which is like a mix-up of Trials and Blood Dragon, essentially. So all the cool, funny stuff from the Blood Dragon DLC and add-on to Far Cry 3, plus the Trials gameplay. And it looks like there's a, I took a look, the trailer itself looked mad. There's all sorts of things you can do on there. It's worth just taking a look at that yourselves. It's difficult to describe, but I'm a big fan of Trials, and you know, I will have to have a look at this one. I think.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a bit of a laugh. I've played a little bit. I need to get back into some Trials because it is just one of those games that you can just lose a few hours. You ain't got to save. It's one of those games you ain't really got to concentrate that you can just lose a couple of hours to fucking about.
Yeah, exactly. It's always it's always good times. For some reason or another, Ubisoft then decided to waffle on about the Assassin's Creed movie.
Yeah.
I had a sit-down chat about that. It's not even talk about it. I mean, it was just... It's just a movie spot to promote it. And it's like, okay, thanks very much.
That game, fucking move on.
Yeah, it's crazy. I don't know why they did that.
They had to, didn't they? They're number one.
Yeah. Unbelievable still, though. Watch Dogs 2, longer gameplay demo here. What did you make of seeing the game in action now through, like, a part of a mission?
Yeah, it looked pretty cool. It looks like you can really change things up. The things you can do, like... you're having that drone and things that sort of mixed it up again. I quite liked how you could combine that with, you can do things on the fly with the drone, like you can hack stuff from that rather than having to be close, like in the first game you had to be in sort of the distance of everything. So this is quite cool. You can plan your route. Mm-hmm. And then when the shit went down, it looked quite cool the way you sort of traverse around with the parkour. And
absolutely. The traversal looks so much smoother.
Yeah.
Looked like that could be actually enjoyable in its own right.
It has hooked me, this one, as much as I still have that sour taste from Watch Dogs.
Yeah, certainly, I think that it showed well here. It was, you know, the demo, with the reveal we saw last week looked decent, but again, it was like, what the hell? Mm. But this demo definitely put me on the route, and I was thinking, right, this could be
the Watch Dogs we wanted.
Possibly. And the only reason I say that they could possibly do this, and people are like, you must be mad saying that, which maybe, but all you've got to do is look back to Assassin's Creed, the original, very first Assassin's Creed, a long, long time ago, 11 years or whatever it was.
Yeah.
And that was promised big. You know, I remember there's a lot of hype for that coming out, and people were banging on about that's going to be the next best thing. Came out, I enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm.
But it was not very, it wasn't overly well received because it was a bit bland. There wasn't a lot to do, so people were not really into it.
No.
Then you take a look at look at Assassin's Creed 2.
Boom.
And that really was
their franchise.
Well, yeah, some people will say it's their favourite in the franchise, and that's what Ubisoft can do. Once they've got a base game in, they can improve things. I think that's the template I'd love to see them follow there. They can get that on that sort of level of watch, you know, the jump from Assassin's Creed to Assassin's Creed 2 in Watch Dogs 2. I'm all in for this because I still think the concept there is very, very clever and good, and there's something good that can be done. They've completely shifted the tone of the game. It's much more lighthearted. It's a little bit dude and bro-y and a little bit too, I don't know, casual in some ways. But, you know, Aiden Bloody Pierce was an absolute bore. So
Aiden Clark
he was renamed Aiden Clark a couple of podcasts ago, which is a bit of a stinker on my behalf.
Made it more exciting, if anything.
It probably did. Absolutely did. But yeah, so did this hype you up more? This is like you had Forever a bit ago, where you was kind of, you know, you weren't really expecting it, and then this.
No, I didn't expect a big gameplay trailer like this. It did, yeah. So the initial announcement that did hype me up, and then I still got those concerns. I'm thinking, is it, you know, we had this last time and it suckered in, it looked fucking brilliant. So as long as it looks like how it played at E3, then it has hyped me up, but I'm still have them sort of reserved hope now that I think, it's going to get downgraded and look fuck all like it did then. But
do you think it will get downgraded?
No, I don't. For some reason, like, it looks good, but it hasn't wowed me. But that first Watch Dogs thing. I remember watching that thinking, fuck, man, this is
next gen. Yeah,
exactly. So this, you look at it and you think, it looks cool, but, you know, I've seen better. Like, Uncharted 4 looked better than this.
So
with that in mind, and they got a lot of stick for that downgrade, so I reckon they've sort of cleaned their act up.
We were talking about DLC and timed exclusives, and we mentioned a couple back then. PlayStation have opted on this one, so they'll be getting DLC packs before 30 days before the Xbox crowds. That's another thing that seems to be happening more and more often, isn't it? That one of the two big guns will come in and say, "All right, time exclusive. That will give you some money for that." They also mentioned, didn't really talk about it too much, Watch Dogs movie.
Oh, really?
It's still in the works, yeah. So I know there's rumours about that. So it looks like they're planning on moving that to a big screen in the near future, and it'll be interesting to see how that happens.
Mm.
Ubisoft then end or shut down their press conference with Steep.
Ooh.
Big surprise. Never heard of it. Not even leaked, as far as I know. And this essentially looks like an open world extreme sport, winter extreme sports game. And we got to see a gameplay demo, and it showed off different types of things you can do. So there's wingsuit challenges you can do there. You've got skiing, you've got snowboarding, base jumping. It all looks very social, very seamless. You do a run down an off piste or whatever, then you save that run, upload the time, and challenge others to do it. It's all that very connective social gaming that we're seeing a lot of, and a bit of a strange thing to end on, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, it was. Yeah,
it was a surprise, to be fair. Well, you know, I'd not expected this, but I don't know what the market is for that.
No, I thought that. A lot of people have been seeing on sort of forums and stuff that there's been a lot of call for an SSX reboot. But yeah, again with you, I think more people would have been up for a Skate 4 than a Steep.
Yeah, well, the trouble with Skate is EA. So every year I tune in for them hoping they'll rebirth that, but they don't, so it's a shame. But this, I mean, fine, they're doing it, they've greenlit it, it's happening.
Yep.
And then we'll see how that one particularly pans out, but I thought it was a little bit of an odd one to be.
Yeah, it's also gameplay of how it worked and stuff. It looks pretty, and it looks like you need to be into that sort of thing.
Yeah, I mean, it's being released later on this year, so you've got it in, it's coming December.
Boom.
That's what they've claimed, so it's not too far away.
Get on down. Get your extreme sports on.
There's also an alpha or a beta for that if you want to sign up. So again, guys, if you're interested, jump on Ubisoft. They've got a couple running. Hopefully you guys can get in and enjoy it. But there you go. That was Ubisoft.
Mm.
We managed to cut through that reasonably without any trouble, but there was so much waffle during that.
Yeah.
It's 2 hours long.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, that was way too long.
But 2 hours is too long, guys. Ubisoft, That's not cool.
Nah.
Towards the end, I was like, Jesus Christ, what are they doing? I actually had to, normally I'll watch it with just on its own, like the what's the name, just the press conference going on.
But yeah.
I got so, like, towards about an hour and 15 minutes in, I was like, I can't sit here and go through this. Like, I know it's not even near the end yet. So I found one of those, like, hangouts that sites do with people, like, just making, like, comments now and again, just to help pass the time. Went into Sifted, it was doing a Twitch stream of it, so I sat and watched that with those guys in the corners taking the piss out of it, and I was like, that's made it a little bit more enjoyable. But 2 hours is too long. What would you give the score for this one?
Because of its length, the games, they did hook me in, a few of them, and again there weren't many surprises other than
Steep
and Trials, maybe. Six.
I'm going to give it a 4.
Oh!
Honestly, the length killed it for me.
Yeah, it was a big stinker. I'm only giving it a 6 because games like Ghost Recon, For Honor, Watch Dogs, I was hyped. They caught my interest, but now I'm like, these games look wicked, all three of them.
Yeah. No, so the Bethesda one, I gave a 7 because it wasn't long. But I think there was probably around the same sort of announcements there, but they didn't long it out.
Yeah,
2 hours. 2 hours, honestly.
It's the longest one out of them all.
Yeah.
Longer than Sony and Microsoft. It's ridiculous.
Honestly, it's absurd. They need to cut that down. It's too long.
Yeah.
Didn't have enough, and I don't think it's nice to be doing that to people. We move on to Sony. So yeah. This was the final one of the actual conventional press conferences.
The daddy.
That's what people have been saying. They've got some after last year, people got high hopes of Sony. Can they deliver? They kick it off nice and well. They've got a live orchestra.
Yeah.
There. And just talking about the presentation, we talked about the waffle that we had to endure and the sit downs and the bollocks for a little bit of Microsoft, but mainly for Ubisoft. Sony, the way they structured it was just roll on trailers back to back.
Yeah.
Have a little 30 seconds, just, you know, this section's VR or whatever, this is our in-house developers. He fucked off stage, didn't come back for 15 minutes because there was four or five trailers back to back, and it was wrapped up within an hour.
Yeah.
Which is beautiful. And when we go through what we had here, there's more than
it's loads.
There. So it kicks off with God of War.
Oh, there we go. Bingo.
So what is this?
Gameplay one of my... I asked for three games this. We've only got one out of three. But this is... Here we go. It looks like it's... It's hard to think. It's called God... Well, I'm assuming it's just called God of War.
Mm-hmm.
The story of God of War is... he's like got the ashes of his dead mother. Dead wife, sorry, and kid on him. So, and that's when he's in his Spartan mode in the Greek mythology. Right. So he's still got that on him, but this is now, he's with his son, which he never had a son. So I don't know if he's after, but he's still got all this body art on him. The Ghost of Sparta thing. So he's, it must Same be after. Kratos. It's Satan Kratos, yeah, but even improved, a bearded Kratos.
Yeah.
Oh, that's what I'm asking for.
Awesome beard.
But now they've gone for a Norse mythology.
Yeah.
Which is a really weird, interesting take on it, but this game looked fucking awesome.
It did look good.
Oh, mate. I was hoping for this. Yeah. It looks like it's set in fucking Skyrim, doesn't it?
It does, yeah.
But it really looked play cool. They've gone for a new behind the shoulder sort of more of immersive sort of Last of Us camera angle,
which
will work better. They're still sticking with their sort of hack and slash thing, but it's more immersive camera angle and sticking with their big action set pieces. But it's definitely a sort of a reimagining. I don't know if you could call it a reboot because.
It seems there's some sort of continuity from the last.
Yeah.
It's odd just to call it God of War. That's the only thing. Maybe it will make a change. You don't know. Cause
I was going
to
say,
indication of release date. At the end, they said it's still in development. They did. It's funny, actually. At the end of the press conference, this is jumping back, but we'll do it now. They had listed off all the games they'd shown, and it would say, like, in development or scheduled for 2016, 2017. I think there was, like, eight games there. And two had a year next to them. The rest are just in development. I had no idea where they were going. But it looked good. It looked he had Kratos' beard. That was moving in the wind during the cutscenes.
Beard physics.
Yeah, beard physics for the wind, definitely. This is my theory. Could be completely wrong. Probably is, but I like to come up with these theories. And I don't know anything about this world. Never played one. And if it is called God of War and nothing else, that'll make me even happier because it'll trick me into thinking I've not missed anything.
Yeah.
No, I have. So you've got this kid there with him. He looks like his son.
Yeah.
He's clearly struggling to be, you know, not a proper father, but, you know, a nice father. He's not in his personality, is it? He's kind of conflicted. Nah. And he's teaching him to hunt. He's going through teaching him to hunt. One thing I notice... When the kid fires a bow, it goes 50 XP when it hits it to archery. So is this some sort of prologue where Kratos is only involved in the first bit, teaching his son, because that's where the 50 XP's come from,
they're
actually going to be running riot with him because Kratos gets wiped out or something?
Do you know what? I think you're onto a winner. Have you heard the last words he says as well at the end of the trailer?
I haven't remembered it. What does he...
I can't remember myself now. No, it's something along the lines of like a new beginning.
Right.
So, yeah, I reckon so.
That's my theory on it.
Yeah, I can see that. But Kratos is such a fucking badass character.
That'll turn people's stomachs.
It will. God of War wouldn't be the same without him. But, I reckon you're onto a winner. It did have that sort of Ellie and Joel sort of feel to it with The Last of Us. But yeah, that could, I reckon you could be onto a right one there. But yeah, that I noticed that you took control of it, but I didn't see that little XP thing.
No, yeah.
That did cross my mind. Like I say, when we listen back to that trailer and just the last words that he says,
yeah,
looks out and sees a dragon and the new world, he sort of said it's a new beginning or something along those lines.
Yeah. Maybe that's what they're alluding to.
Yeah, but that was one of my three I wanted. So we started off with a big bang there.
Absolutely loving that. We're then going to move on to Days Gone, which initially was shown early in the press conference as a CG trailer. Mm-hmm. I was kind of like, what's this? Sons of Anakin? What?
Yeah.
I can't work it out. And then at the very end, they actually close with a Days Gone gameplay trailer. So I might as well just do it in one go.
Yeah.
CG trailer, I was like, oh, I don't really understand what this is. Gameplay trailer, you get a lot more of an idea of what this is. Yeah. I can't, in all good faith, not mention that it gave me the Last of Us vibes. Just
mate, the whole time in the gameplay trailer, they're like zooming through the world or the map and stuff. And do you remember on The Last of Us, just before the end, when you go to like, is it like,
hold up? Watch these spoilers for people.
Oh, of course. It's not really much a spoiler, but it's just you go to an area. In The Last of Us, and it's like a water station, I don't know, like a water pump place.
All right, yeah.
And the thing in there, in this what's it called, Days Gone trailer, it looked very similar to that. So I was just waiting for Joel to turn up at any minute. It's gonna be the whole time. I was convinced that it was The Last of Us 2.
Yeah,
I really did think that it was gonna be.
It's a new IP in a similar sort of setting.
Yeah.
Seeing the gameplay actually run, mechanics looked a little bit rusty, but the main takeaway I had from this was it's set in the same, it's an apocalyptic world, all that sort of business. That's why you get the Last of Us vibes of it. Everything's all a bit broken. But in terms of the zombies or the infected, whatever you want to call them, they're completely different. These guys come in hordes.
Yeah.
They come in hordes. So
big hordes.
Yeah, it's honestly on the screen, there's like hundreds of them running at them. They pile over like through doors, tripping over each other. It is really impressive seeing
them
chasing the main character up and around this environment. I was really impressed with the way they were just sort of flooding through doors.
Yeah.
And I noticed a few bits where they would get really close to him and wouldn't do anything. So I don't know.
I did wonder that.
I hope the game doesn't let you get away with that sort of thing. I think it's just because the demo. I didn't want him getting fucking ripped to pieces.
Yeah,
but
probably had God mode on.
Exactly. But yeah, I was really impressed with this Bend Studio, who, if you don't know who they are, they've done the portable versions of Uncharted, which weren't the best, but they've done Siphon Filter back in the day, which was one of my... I did love Siphon Filter. It was just too hard for me, so I never got to get through it when I was younger. Mm. But I was impressed with this. This is what they ended on. So, Sony are obviously, they're saying this is it. And people will go, oh, it's just another Last of Us clone. It's like, well...
Yeah, it did have that feel. The way the sort of main character would talk while he was walking around the map, that had a very Last of Us feel.
Yeah.
But it suckered me, and I think they started well and ended well so far.
Yeah.
They're on the roll.
It's no bad thing, is it, to be compared to The Last of Us, so...
Nah, not at all.
Can't complain about that. It then kicks another gear in. We get the Last Guardian pop up again. We get a little gameplay sort of trailer going on.
What did you think of this?
Main takeaway was we've got a release date, 25th of October 2016, so hopefully that won't slip. I like the look of it. It looked a little bit more exciting than what they showed last year, where it's just him jumping across a gap, picking you up, and I was like, oh Christ, what are they doing? And there were two trichos. There was his tricho, like the beast thing, and there's also another one there. So I imagine there's going to be points where you pit him against other beasts and stuff, which could be quite cool. But I'm sold on it.
It does look good, but one thing that I just thought, it looked poor graphically.
Graphically, it looks. I'll tell you what it is. It doesn't help that the main kid in it is almost cel-shaded or cartoony compared to the environments. And it's typical Ico sort of, if I think back to Ico and Shadow of the Colossus, and not so much, but in Ico is a bit like that. The characters always looked a little bit out of place. But yeah, I get what you mean. It's a bit jarring to see.
Yeah, well, I've never played any of them two. I've heard great things about them. But so yeah, this is my first impressions of this sort of genre and game. And I've got to say, it really did sort of distance me from it. I did sort of look at it and sort of think it doesn't, I don't know, it doesn't, it's it's not sitting well with me for some reason. The game looks like mechanics and stuff looks fun, and
yeah,
I'm hyped for it. But yeah, just graphically, it wasn't doing it for me.
No, graphically it doesn't look good. I admit that it doesn't, certainly doesn't. But we will see. I mean, graphics to me are never the be all and end all.
Otherwise,
I would have one of your rigs sitting there, absolutely bossing it. But then I wouldn't be playing The Last Guardian, would I? Or Horizon Zero Dawn, which was again
graphically demoed.
Graphically amazing. Very good. Yeah. So Guerrilla Games has done a good job here. Horizon Zero Dawn gameplay demo showed a little bit of combat, showed traversal, showed some dialogue options.
Yeah, it looked like a sort of Mass Effect style.
Yeah, a little wheel. I don't mind a bit. I love a bit of that. Give me some choice. Give me some choice.
They're going to have that in FIFA.
Oh, well.
In that career mode, they're going to have a Mass Effect wheel. Interesting. But yeah, no, this looks fucking. This looks cool, this does. Again, like I was saying earlier, Sony just. Like, obviously, we knew about this one, but
yeah. They
do just drop AAA new IPs every year, and they're fucking. They all look cool.
Yeah, they're doing a really, really good job of keeping things fresh.
Yep.
I like this, the demo they showed. You can override other creatures, can't you? And use them as mounts. You can knock this. It looks quite destructible. The trees all get knocked down. Yep. You can place static bombs. The only thing that really is irking me with this is, you can fire like a torpedo rope into
right,
them,
and it holds them down.
Holds them down.
Yep.
What I noticed is when it was hitting the creature, and we've seen this in the demos last year, when it's in the creature, it's not always connected to the creature. It's kind of...
Oh, really?
It's really bothering me.
Oh, I've not had a look at that.
It wouldn't ruin the game, but it's just one of those things that you pick up on. It was just annoying me, and I was like, oh, please just try and tighten that up. I know it's really difficult because the physics of that must be so hard to work out, depending on where you hit it in its body, where you then put down the stick in the ground, then how it's moving. I can't imagine how they've programmed that. It looks good if you're not nitpicking at it, and it's a great tactic it looks like to use, just to pin down these creatures. But Horizon Zero Dawn, it's on the list. And I think we were both, well, I certainly thought not going to be getting much out of this because we had almost a reveal last week. It's like another demo, and it's saying it's been released, and it's been delayed into 2017.
February, is it?
Yeah, so we've got February the 28th in North America and March the 1st in the EU, March the 3rd over here in the UK, although that tends to change, although if Brexit around the corner, it might not, it might fucking sting us. But yeah, it's not actually that far away, considering it was people going, oh, it's meant to be this year. And it's only in February, like the end of February, March. It's not that far away. And looking forward to that. New IP, new ideas. Guerrilla Games finally got the shackles of Killzone. Fucking binned off, so they can go away and do that. More new stuff coming. Detroit Become Human. Quantic Dream game. Lots of people don't like these games, and I can totally understand why they don't. But I fucking love them. So.
Yeah, I'm a big fan. This was announced last year, was it?
Yeah.
They've looked like they've changed it up a bit now. I don't know if there was a woman. I don't know if they're going to have certain sections, but it was a girl last time, wasn't it?
Sure, yeah, it's an a female android, and this time it was almost like a negotiator, wasn't it?
An
android trained to be negotiated. I can't remember off the top of my head what
his name. Colin or something like that.
Connor. He looked like a cop as well.
Yeah, it did.
But so this showed off like a little, it's like a gameplay trailer where it showed off a situation where there's a guy on a roof, an android with a girl, like a human girl, on a, not a rooftop, but on like a high ledge inside a building, and he's got her on the edge, and he's like, oh, I'm going to jump off and kill her. And you're Connor, the guy you're playing, you're sent in to examine the area, pick up evidence, try and find out clues, and then go out there and confront this man, and obviously try and talk him down, and just get the girl safe, really, because there's obviously a friction between the androids and between humans, and an android then killing a little girl could prove disastrous in that relationship. That'll just spark off all sorts of android abuse, and there's going to be some real, I think there's going to be some really interesting themes in this game, exploring
politics
between, I mean, it sounds ridiculous, but humans and androids, whether they count as being humans and that sort of thing. But I like the fact that it was they're still going with the idea that decision making is key in this game, and it impacts the outcome. There's lots of possibilities for this. There was tons and tons of different of fails, and I don't know if they were fail states, well, that just happens. There's ones where he just jumps off of the girl. There's one where he shoots the android and he dies. One where you can talk them both down. There's all sorts of stuff that can happen, and that's what they're good at, these games, is giving you the choice and allowing those choices to actually have meaningful consequences.
Yep, I'm sucked. I'm hooked.
Detroit Become Human. Not everyone's cup of tea, I completely understand, but for me, that's an earmarked one. No release date for that, though. Then PlayStation, or Sony rather, then move into their VR part.
Yep.
So we had the outline that it's coming October the 13th, so official release date rather than just October, which we had before. And they say it's going to be 50 games.
Ooh.
50 bloody games.
50 bloody games.
In 2016, I would bet a large portion of money they're not all big games. Some will be 40 seconds long or 40 minutes long. But when we talk about VR, we saw The Kitchen return, didn't we?
Yeah.
Now, I remember we go back to the nearly a year ago when we was going to EGX?
EGX
in Birmingham. We got to have a go on PlayStation VR. Yep. I got a demo called The Kitchen, which is made by Capcom. And I tore it a new one. I said that is...
Oh, it was dog shit.
So that is a shit demo to show people who are interested in VR. Apparently, we're in the minority because people have been raving about that, saying how terrifying it was. Well,
they're wrong.
Say they're wrong. So we got The Kitchen return. And I was like, oh, God. And it says, before The Kitchen, there was... And we get this kind of like first person, really spooky, like PT-esque.
Outlast-esque.
Yeah, demo playing. And it's like, oh, this looks a bit scary, actually.
Turns out
it's only Resident Evil fucking 7.
Yeah, fucking brilliant.
So there we go. Resident Evil 7 will come to all platforms, but the kicker is you can play through the game start to finish on PlayStation VR. So it's going to be... I don't know if I could sit through that in VR. That would be. And the release date, 24th of January 2017.
So not far off.
Well, yeah. It's far off, but you know, I know what you mean. It's in terms of most of the stuff here. But yeah, that was a big shock to me. It's a complete departure of Resident Evil. It looks like I can only assume it's all going to be in first person.
Yeah.
And yeah, playable demo out now on the PlayStation Store.
Yeah, it'd be interesting because it's obviously looks like a massive reboot, but it'd be interesting to see if they're sticking with characters like, you know, will we see Leon or Chris, Redfield? I'd
fucking bin it, I'd say.
Yeah, just start all fresh.
What's the point?
Yeah,
it's done enough that lot.
Yeah, that's true.
Honestly, I'll be disappointed if they try and shoehorn them in. It's not as though they're like fully fleshed out characters anyway.
Nah, true.
Just the guys that have been knocking around. I know you're not happy with that, are you? You're like,
you've put a dowler on it now. No, I do love my Resi, but I do agree that series has, like, after 6 and...
Yeah, if I get a choice between having Resi 6 with all the characters from the main story in it and this, with no old characters... No old characters, and I'll have this, thanks.
Yeah,
it doesn't feel like Resident Evil though.
Nah, that's the thing. I really thought they were going to sort of make a Leon comment or something that sort of made you think, but it really is a steer from the series, and it'd be interesting to see how they go with it. But it's looking fucking cool and fucking scary as well.
Yeah, it was a surprise to see it in that form. That was I'm not surprised we saw Resident Evil 7, but to see it in that state.
Yeah,
a surprise. Although I've got
demo as well. That really shocked me.
Yeah, playable demos there. So I mean, I've played through it, and I'll go through that at some point in the future. But it's up on our YouTube channel now if you want to watch that playthrough. Although I highly recommend if you've got a PlayStation 4 just to play the bloody thing yourself and get through it. So some more PSVR games that popped up, and something called Farpoint, which is like a shooter. We had the PlayStation VR Mission X-Wing for Battlefront. Finally announced Batman Arkham VR being made by Rocksteady. So that's obviously going to be an exclusive there on the PlayStation VR. Final Fantasy 15 VR experience, and you get to play as Prompto
the bird, who was actually a male character in previous titles. She's had her cock cut off.
Oh, God. It's a weird thing to do. That, out of all the demos, that looked the worst.
Yeah, it did, to be honest, yeah.
Oh, Final Fantasy. What are they doing with that thing?
They're really pushing for it, isn't it? Because PlayStation do have quite an allegiance with the Final Fantasy Japanese and all that, so it looks like they're really pushing for this VR, going, come on, we need everyone aboard, and they've gone, oh, all right, then we'll stick a little cheeky demo in.
Yeah, it looked really bad, though.
Did look a bit poor.
Well, honestly, it's been a terrible week of Final Fantasy 15, I think.
Yeah, I suppose it has been with that poor gameplay.
Yeah, it's not really looked good. And that was basically what they had for the VR. They did, what they didn't do, which annoyed me, is they went into the Call of Duty Infinite Warfare trailer and didn't mention it wasn't VR anymore.
Oh, right, yeah.
I got really confused and thought, wow, this looks like the tits.
Yeah, I've got to say, for this guy, until it actually... It began off in like a space station, didn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
And up until that, until we actually got out and then got a gun... Then I sort of started to twing. I thought, this looks a lot like COD. Oh, of course it is COD. Yeah. But up until that, I just thought this was a new IP, and I thought it looked fucking awesome.
Yeah. So, yeah, just to confirm, that's not VR as far as I know, but they didn't. They were doing like a bundle of VR games, and suddenly this just appeared. Wasn't made clear that it wasn't VR, and it looked really good. And I was like, this is good. And then realised it was Call of Duty, and it wasn't. But actually, the campaign itself...
Yeah.
The trailer itself looked pretty good. But
yeah, they tend to do this. Like, they do sucker you in with the old trailer campaign. You think it does look awesome, but that's probably fucking half of the campaign we watch, yeah?
Yeah, it's probably right there.
It's the only shame. But like I say, without not thinking it was Call of Duty, I was watching that thinking, fucking cool, this looks like an awesome space game. Even when he got out, I was like, wow. And then all of a sudden, the start of mechanics started kicking in. I thought... Yeah, it's quite Call of Duty-esque. Oh, it's Call of Duty.
I wonder if that was never released with a Call of Duty tag, whether people would still...
Yeah, want to go, oh, look at cool fucking space.
Yeah, exactly. No, Call of Duty tag's ruined. They had a mention of Call of Duty 4 Legacy.
Oh, yeah, they did show a little trailer for that as well, didn't they?
Yeah. I mean, my stream kind of broke out, but it seemed to suggest that the campaign will arrive 30 days early on PS4 as well.
Oh,
don't know if that's been confirmed, or I should have really checked it before... You know, mentioning it, but I thought that that was going to be appearing later on. I don't see how they would actually do that, thinking about it.
No, it would be difficult unless they've got some sort of alignment with them. They tend to do, don't they? I suppose if things got a Battlefield one, Xbox, they've got some sort of content coming early, so I wonder if PlayStation have sided with...
Just doing the research on the fly. Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered campaign comes early to PlayStation 4.
Confirmed here at Dim Digital, your number one stop
for
news.
There's lots of rumours in circulation, and this wasn't confirmed, but finally, we'll put to bed what is going on with Crash Bandicoot.
Oh, yeah.
1, 2, and Warped are getting remastered, and he's going to appear in Skylanders Imaginations come October. PS4 remasters of Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah, I think... You know, after the... actually, I won't talk about that.
Well, no, so essentially, that we've played a part of Crash Bandicoot, and I wouldn't want to go back and play them anymore. I think that we leave that franchise because they were really... It's really awkward, and it's not... I was talking to Dave Salmon, and he was like, oh, I'm really hyped for that. He sold his PS4 still. Oh, guys, I'm really hyped for that. Yeah, he sold it. It's gone. Couldn't handle it. What did he monitor? So fair enough. But he's obviously it'd be really good, the nostalgia. And I just thought, you're mad. After playing a part of it lately, unless they improve the controls, it's great for its time.
Yeah, they did say it was going to be like, you saw the character, didn't you, what he's going to look like in the Skylanders trailer. So it looks like it's going to have to be a beefy remaster. But as I said before, with the hype and success of the new Ratchet and Clank game.
Yeah, you'd want a remake. We'd want a new version of it. That's what modern version of it. I think playing these, there'll be a lot of people who go, what the fuck?
Didn't even know there was one called Warped.
No, nor did I, exactly. Need just do 1 and 2, thanks.
Yeah.
Force Awakens Lego demo, that is out. You can go and play that now. There's a little trailer for that. No much news there. We knew that's definitely coming. Then there was some big news.
Yeah.
The big man himself, Hideo Kojima, returned.
Say that again.
Hideo Kojima. I've changed it. tried to do it the actual proper way, and it's impossible. But Kojima returns to the big stage.
He does, and he fucked that up, didn't he?
he was struggling, wasn't he? The trouble is, I don't think he speaks any
accent. No, not that bit. No, as he's walking onto the stage, there was like this sort of like glowing light underneath him.
Oh, yeah, he walked too quick.
Yeah, he did, didn't he? Kojima, you fucked it up.
Yeah, so they made a big thing of it. Like, there's a massive curtain on this stage, and they lift it up, and they're like, "I'd like to present you one of the most creative minds in gaming." And Kojima's standing there, and it's all dark, and as he walks down, there's like lighted steps for him, and obviously the steps don't exist when he lights, they're there anyway, and he walked a bit too quick and got ahead of the lights.
That really made me chuckle.
Hundreds and thousands of pounds wasted on getting the light. He just strolled straight through it, but he was there to talk about his new game, show it off. So we saw it must be a CG trailer of it, called,
yeah, it was all in engine, wasn't it? All in game footage.
Well, can he be trusted with that?
Yeah, that's the truth. What do they call that? Is it
just in engine?
In engine footage? Oh, well, there is a word for it, I've forgotten now, but it was got a name for the game as well, which is
Death Stranding. New IP was going to be, wasn't it? It's coming from that studio,
but fuck me, did this game look weird?
This is the thing. I expected this to be weird. I mean, it's got Norman Reedus in it as well, we should mention.
Yeah, so I was waiting to see the Del Toro link up as well. Yeah. It doesn't look like at the...
I remember reading something saying he's never touching games again because every time he gets involved with one, it gets been...
I suppose it has, isn't he? Poor fucker, we put him right off.
Yeah, he feels like he's just like a bad omen for it all. But nothing. But yeah, so it's a really weird kind of trailer for it. It's like this on this beach, isn't it, where there's loads of dead crabs and whales washed up. Norman Reedus is laying there naked. He's got handcuffs on. He wakes up.
Weird handcuffs as well.
Yeah, he's got like a little electrical thing on it. And then he wakes up and there's a baby crying. It's got a cable coming out of it. He picks it up and he's like, crying. So obviously he knows who it is. That then disappears. And then
he starts seeing all the footprints of the baby walking about. And he's got oil on his hands.
Yeah, that's it. He's got oil on his hands. He looks out and the sea's just derelict, just like dead whales and creatures and what. And then Death Stranding pops up.
And then there's five characters, isn't there, just floating in the air looking at him.
Yeah.
That's very weird.
Very, very weird. But well, I don't know what we expected. As soon as
he
took liberties with Metal Gear, so to get completely off the hook, off the chain rather, he's always going to produce something. But we know something's happening.
Yeah, we know something's happening, and it's caught me, and I'm hooked.
It does look good. It's gonna, hopefully it doesn't take 7 years
for him
to fucking make it. But we will see Death Stranding, another little coup for Sony. Although that one, I believe they mentioned, will be available on PC a long time ago, so it won't be a complete exclusive, but it won't be available on Xbox to start with, at least. Another little surprise for people who are watching this press conference. And one of the biggest surprises actually for me was Insomniac Games announcing they're going to be making the next Spider-Man game.
Yeah,
still can't confirm whether that's an exclusive to PlayStation. I guess it's not, but
yeah,
have it that late on in the press conference and
almost like they're closing out thing, wasn't it? Obviously they did go and close with Days Gone, but but having this late on, it was a weird one. It does look good, though, I must admit.
Yeah, no, I mean, I'll tell you what. Of all the superhero games I've played, I've not played a great deal of them. I always loved Spider-Man 2. That was real good. The only thing I didn't like about this one was his outfit. Like the
water. Yeah, it did look a bit weird. It looks like they've sort of made it more cartoony. I mean, it does look like it ties in with the movie that's coming out. Like, he's looking more cartoony in the new Avengers, Captain America Civil War film.
But
that's one thing that did cross my mind, to be honest, that weird costume.
Yeah, but I love it. Spider-Man, I think, is a great game-based character to use, just because of the powers swinging through an open world. It fits some really good gaming conventions, and we've had some good ones in the past, especially with 2, so there's no reason why Insomniac, who've just come off the back of, you know, Ratchet and Clank getting great reviews. I've just purchased that today, so that's coming.
Gosh.
See a review for that. So they're on a high. They're in collaboration with Sony. I'm on the PlayStation US blog site now, and they've revealed that Spider-Man games coming exclusively to PlayStation 4, according to this. So, wow, that is not going to be appearing anywhere else. Which is if it's good, it's a good coup for them, and it's, you know, it'll be coming out, I imagine. Isn't it? You say there's another Marvel film coming out next. Is there going to be one next year?
What's that? Another? So, oh yeah, Spider-Man. Yeah,
Spider-Man. It's standalone, won't it? That'll be coming out. So I don't know.
Yeah.
This won't be linked to that, but I
no, no, they'll probably try and tie it up so it's similar, so it gets you hyped and then bush.
Yeah.
But yeah,
interested.
Yeah, I will be. Yeah, yeah. I did play one of the newer ones. I think they did like an Amazing Spider-Man they released. I did play number two of that, and I've got to say that was quite enjoyable.
All right,
so I will. It probably won't be a D1 purchase, but once it's around the same sort of mark that you've paid for Ratchet and Clank.
Well, yeah, if it comes out at that sort of price, which is like the £30 mark, and they've got good pedigree, Insomniac are on a higher now, as I said, so no reason why it can't be good.
No, one to watch, I think.
Probably my favourite superhero, and I don't really get into it too much, but
for me, but if you're being picky.
Well, I've got Batman VR, so you can
still... Yeah.
That's coming. Also, see Telltale, Batman, it's all kicking off.
Yeah.
It's all coming back again. But that's the end of the Sony press conference and all of the main press conferences for E3. We have done it somehow.
Boom.
Completely changed the plan.
Yeah,
this was all meant to be one big long episode, and this is a long one. But obviously, we're going to have EA and Bethesda's in there as well, and come out Sunday. I just thought this is not going to work. Let's just put them out when they're ready. So, I hope you guys are able to listen to this at a decent time and get through it all. It's I wish I'd planned it like this. I could have done some better planning, but
wasn't
to be, but we've done it. We've got Sony.
We have back. Done it.
Last week we've got to score it, yeah.
Yeah, I was just thinking that before we forget.
Go on then.
I will go for, and to take the title of E3,
yeah.
I'm giving this an 8.
Yeah, I'm going to give it an 8.5.
Oh, it's gone higher.
You know what? It's not even... the thing is, it's done everything that's required. It's a load of new... There's not new IPs there. There's existing surprises. There's some interesting stuff. Good, yeah. And that's the main thing. It's under an hour. So actually, I'll give it a 9, just because it's under an hour. If Ubisoft are going to get punished for having 2 hours so bad, this should be praised for having everything to get that amount in under an hour and have little waffle, just constant trailers. It was just great, and that live orchestra was amazing to see those guys go. So the championship does go. When it's this, all the stuff we've been talking about, there's going to be more details out there as the week goes on, as people get their hands on the game. So maybe we will return Saturday when I am back from the stag do to see if there's anything major that's come out since then. There's still publishers and games that are going to be, trailers are going to be dropped and things like that. Oh, so
we've got the Nintendo stuff, haven't we?
Nintendo's going on as we speak, and I watched about 20 minutes of that stream of Zelda, and I'll tell you what, that looks fucking good.
Nice. I'll be looking forward to watch that.
That looks really, really good, Zelda. Hope that comes out and does a good job, but I got to say I was very impressed with Zelda, the Breath of the Wild.
Ooh, is that what they're calling it?
Yeah. So yeah, that's that for me. I think, you know, I'm going to ask you the question before, actually. What do you think is going to get Game of the Show?
Game of the Show. Well, for me, it will be God of War.
Yep.
I'm just thinking, I reckon it could be a toss-up between that and That Day's Gone. I can see a lot of people liking That Day's Gone.
Right.
It's
out of those two.
Yeah, see, another one is Battlefield. You don't realise how big Battlefield is, really, do you, until you see that, and how many people are hyped for that. Even these people that I call FIFA gamers, I think even they have a little interest in it.
Yeah, you're probably right.
But then Resi, there's too much to choose from.
I'm going to say it now. I think just because the amount there is to play for Zelda,
the
long demo, that's all they've got in the shop floor.
Right.
That's going to get Game of the Show for me. And it looks incredible as well, so that helps. Nice. And the fact that it's going to probably be one of the most in-depth, hands-on demos that people get, that for me, I think, is going to take it.
Actually, I'm changing my mind. I'm going with Witcher card game. Game of the Year.
Unbelievable. Well, there you go. That is this wrapped up. We will be back, if not on Sunday, this coming Sunday. We'll be back the following Sunday to do a full
live from wash up bed.
Yeah, if I'm still alive. So I'm not sure what's going to happen, if there's going to be a third part of this E3 week or not. We'll just have to see if there's anything that interesting that happens between now and then, if we get, you know, there's stuff missing, like there was no Naughty Dog there, you know, Rockstar, they were missing as well. So you never know, these things could change. If something big happens, we'll obviously jump on and talk about it for as long as we can, and that'll arrive at the earliest Saturday, at the latest Sunday. If not, the following Sunday we'll be back, and it should be some sort of normality. So we'll see what happens. But thanks for joining me, Tom. It's been a pleasure having you on here. You guys at home, obviously, if you just subscribe, if you are listening, head over to the YouTube, the Twitter, the Facebooks of the world, /DimpDigital. You can find us. And if you want to get in contact, you can use those channels as well. We've also recently just dropped the live version of our Apple iOS app. So the Chappers, the webmaster, has built that from the ground up, and it's out there for you guys to get your hands on. So head over to the Apple Store and download that now. It's in an early version, so there's going to be bits and pieces there that you're going to might have to endure, but it'll give you a good insight of where we're going with this and what we want to do. So thanks to Mr. Chappers for doing that. Mr. Adkins, pleasure to have you here once again.
Thank you, and goodbye.
Everyone else, thanks for your time, and ta-da.